Doug Wiley with Police One. I'm here with Mike Foreman with Point Blank Body Armor. It's great to see you, Mike. Mike, can you tell me about some of the trends that you're seeing in the body armor industry and body armor overall?
Well, first, we'd like to say thank you. At Point Blank and PACA Body Armor, we make product that saves lives. So being here at the largest tactical event in America, we're so honored to be here because that's what we do, is we produce body armor that saves lives. And there are growing trends. As we know, the last 18 months to 2 years, we've had an increase in officers being shot and killed in the line of duty. So it is our responsibility to produce new products to meet the emerging threats that officers face today.
So some of those new products, can you tell me about any variety or any number of things that you're looking at in terms of the specific things you're building into them in order to ameliorate or meet those threats?
Well, there's a new NIJ standard for body armor. It's the 0101.06 body armor. We have more certified ballistic models than anyone in the body armor industry. And today, we have 37 ballistic models that are certified to the new standard. And why we have so many is we want to give officers a choice for the mission and the operation they may be serving to make sure we meet a variety of needs. And so what we're seeing is emerging threats with a host of different type of bullets and ammunition. So to make sure we're responsive to those threats, we develop new ballistic solutions, and we have a new solution, our tri-compliant package just came out in the last 2 weeks, that it meets the certification of both NIJ, FBI, and DEA, which is the first in the industry, and we'll talk more about that later.
Yeah. So one of the things that I was noticing here in the booth here at the NTOA in Virginia is that you've got a variety of different types of carrier solutions.
Yes.
And I think that they also, I was noticing some of the functionality there, they also meet some very specific needs for the officer out on the street. Can you tell me about some of those things?
Well, one thing we're seeing is the different needs and missions, and so we want to be responsive to those missions of different regions of the country or operations that may be engaged in. So it's really about a modularity or being able to start with a base vest and build up based on the need. So whether a rural operation, urban operation, going through the door for maximum coverage and protection, we want to make sure that we have a variety of products that meets all those needs. And one of the ones we have here is our Q4.
Okay, so yeah, the Q4 is specifically one of the ones that I wanted to talk about. We have an example here, Hoyt's wearing. My understanding is that you've done something very unique here in the ability to unass the vest.
Right. Well, we have a deep history with the U.S. military. We have delivered 1.7 million vests to the Army since our war in Iraq. So we're very familiar with the needs of the Army, and a lot of this grows out of the military needs. And now we went to the IOTV for the Army, which is based on a quick-release system.
Yeah.
So we thought we could improve upon that because in field and in training, you want to encourage the use of that so you're very familiar. And what's very unique and what Hoyt's going to show is how it instantaneous release, but even a beauty of it also, it reassembles in less than a minute, even by an untrained user.
Mm-hmm. Let's take a look. It's pretty darn impressive.
Amazing.
Very
so
impressive.
You have excellent coverage area, yep. Modular can be built up, instantaneous release before training.
Yep.
It can be reassembled in 30 seconds to a minute, which is great, because then you're going to tend to want to train with it. We want to make it user-friendly, effective, and well-designed.
Right. One of the other things I noticed here at the booth is that you've got a man-portable shield.
Yes.
It looks like it's extremely easy to operate. And Hoyt's now got one of those now for us to take a look at. Can you tell me about that?
Well, we were looking, again, trying to determine what are the needs of law enforcement in the U.S. today. And we've been very familiar since the late 90s and active shooters and trend of active shooters. And it's just not about a patrol or SWAT response. It's both. So we wanted to develop a product that would be used by the tactical team in a host of environments, from going through the door to a sniper, but also that a patrol officer could have it in his trunk, be very portable, very affordable,
yep.
And be able to deal with that active shooter threat, and this is what we have here today. So what happens here, we can easily, very portable storage, unroll it, and now we have full body coverage. It can go into a shooting position. It also has a configuration that it can stand up on its own. A sniper can sit behind it. So both patrol and SWAT application, if you will, very usable, very portable. Even units such as border protection that deal with tunnels and things like that. A lot of different uses could apply to this product.
Outstanding. One of the other things that I noticed here today at the NTOA was what's right behind you.
Yes,
and that's this Dragonfire. And this is very new from you guys. Can you tell me a little bit more about that?
Well, the Dragonfire, this is the second generation. And so what we've updated, listening to our end users what they need. One of the most popular vests in America today, agencies such as the City of Miami, Philadelphia PD, and many others use this product today. And we've upgraded it based on the feedback from the end users. And we want to make it modular today so that when you get a vest from us, it's a very complete system. So there's no add-on additional cost. But we, from listening to the users, we added some additional features. So a lot of adjustability in this vest. That is one of the best features about this. So in most of the tactical teams in America in law enforcement are part-time teams, and you may have turnover in personnel. So we want a lot of adjustability. So both on the side coverage with overlapping ballistics and in the shoulders, we give us up to a 4-inch window, which means is we could have a swing of probably of 25 pounds of an end user in the same size vest. But we also want to take in mind that it be built for the tactical operator to be able to shoot from a natural position. Some of the features that we've incorporated are improvements are it's a standard two-piece collar that's removable, a retractable groin. It comes with overlapping side ballistics. Additional features are the throat protectors and biceps. Also a standard feature on our tactical products are they can add actually special threat plates to the biceps and sides, and that's a standard feature that encompasses. The other thing we've incorporated, or what we refer to as kangaroo pouches, in addition to the 5 pouches that comes with the product, we have 4 of these so that you could store rifle magazines, handgun magazines, or other additional storage, very low profile, shooter with a shooter in mind. And then based on some recent requests, we've also added additional over-the-shoulder protection, if you will. We had several agencies want this because they want to provide additional maximum coverage, that distance between the bicep and over the shoulder, so that when the shooter is in that natural position, there is no exposed area. So again, it's about saving lives. And so that's why, and again, all these, it's upgradable. We've extended the coverage area of the throat protector. Mm-hmm. We also have, and what is one of the best features, is a shock absorber system. So that traditionally, the tactical vest sits on you as a turtle shell, if you will. So you get the movement of an entire unit. The shock absorber allows it so that you adjust it so the weight is distributed through those strapping systems. So when fully loaded, with that additional 15 to 25 pounds of gear that the operator is going to carry, fatigue doesn't become a factor. But when I move, reach, or crawl, I don't get that turtle shell effect. So again, tremendous, and we're the only one in the industry that offers that today. So that's one of the reasons, among the many others, that this is such a popular item.
Point Blank is also alone, as far as I understand, in the industry. And one other thing, and you began to touch on it, and that's tri-compliance.
Right.
You began to discuss how that's begun to play a part in your product line. Can you tell me more about how it came to be, and tell me more about the details of it?
Well, we're constantly looking at the threat that officers face today and emerging threats, and even on a global standard. So we, not just in the U.S. law enforcement, from a global law enforcement perspective, and could some of those threats face us in the U.S. We also be aware that there's a new NIJ standard. We have a difficult testing protocol for the FBI standard and DEA. And part of that DEA requirement is fragmentation. So 2-grain, 4-grain, 17-grain, and 64-grain simulate is shrapnel, IEDs and other devices that just not the military but law enforcement could face today. So we want to afford maximum protection against all range of bullets, including special threats. Please keep in mind that NIJ is going to test 2 basic rounds for a level 3A, the 357 SIG and 44. We want to make sure that we understand that. So in this tri-compliant model that we have developed called the F3A, we far exceed, and I'll share with you, like NIJ requirement of 1,470 feet per second. In the 357 SIG, in a conditioned state, we're over 1,900 feet per second. And for one of the first time anywhere in the industry, our 9mm exceeds 2,000 feet per second. It's about officers' safety and level of protection. But we did it at a low weight. So again, keep in mind we have to have comfort and flexibility as a factor when you design a system. So what we've achieved is listening to the end users, meeting the demands of both law enforcement at a domestic and global standard, but also meeting the federal requirements as we understand it today. So we're very excited. There's nothing else like it in the industry today.
Right. Well, Mike, thank you very much for everything you guys do for law enforcement. You do save lives, and that's important to us here at Police One.
Well, thank you. And what you do for information, getting out to the law enforcement community, great service, and it's about information. Thank you for the opportunity.
Thanks a lot. Talk to you soon.
Okay.
Doug Wiley with Police One.